Good morning students, I am Pavan, your science master. Students, in this video I am going to talk to 7th standard students. Students, we have been talking about the 4th chapter, that's motion and time. In this chapter we have completed the types of motions. I just gave you the names of the types of motions. In this video I will give definitions of the types of motions. First, let me write the names of the types of motions. First one is translatory motion. Students, let me write the definition. If a body is moving in straight path, that is in translatory motion, that is said to be in translatory motion. If a body is moving in straight path or straight line, okay, again this moment is in two types. One is rectilinear . Another one is the moment of a body, you know, that may be in rectilinear motion. If it is in straight line, that is rectilinear motion. If it is in straight line, for example, you take a car is, you know, for example, if you take the car is moving in a straight line, you know, straight path, okay, then this car is said to be in rectilinear motion, okay. The moment, the direction of the car is in straight line, then that is said to be in rectilinear motion. If the same car, if it is moving like this, okay, then the car is said to be in a curvilinear motion. Understood, no, students? You want to take the definition? Rectilinear motion. If a body is in translatory motion, if a body is in translatory motion and moves in a straight line, okay, straight line, then that is said to be rectilinear motion. Moves along, here one more point, moves along a straight line, moves along a straight line. And if you want to know what is curvilinear motion, you can change the definition here itself. You can see that if a body is in translatory motion and moves in a curve line, here you have to change it. I change it and I will write it on the board. You try to understand, students. See, if body is in translatory motion and moves. How? Here you have to say moves along a straight line or curve line. Curve line. Then that is said to be curvilinear motion. Okay, students, like this you have to understand what is translatory motion. Translatory motion is of two types, that is, you know, rectilinear motion and curvilinear motion. A table will be displayed on the screen, you can see there. I'll explain how the moment of that the objects given in the table, and then you have to identify what type of motion the objects possess. Yeah, you can see there in the table, observing the path of the motion. In first, soldier marching in a parade. Soldiers marching in a parade, straight line or curve line? They move in a straight line, right? Yes. So they have what? Rectilinear motion. And then next, car taking a turn on road. Turn, you have to understand here, turn means there is some curve. So the car possesses curvilinear motion. Next, stone dropped from a height. How does the stone travel or move from the point where you drop it to the ground? Stone dropped from a height that moves in straight line, and that possesses what? Rectilinear motion. And then running race along a road. Along a road, along a road. Road may be in curve line, the road may be in straight line. So the running race is always conducted in a straight line, so that you have to understand that is in rectilinear motion. And then running race along a track on a ground. Yeah, ground in the sense it's a fixed place, right? The place, you know, they put some tracks with, you know, some white paint or something, you know. They design some tracks. They draw some tracks on the ground. So the running race is conducted, and the runners run in the tracks, in between the tracks. Okay, so that is not in straight, right? That is in curve line. So that the running race along a track on ground possesses curvilinear motion. Okay, moment of bicycle on a road. Moment of bicycle on a road, that may be, the road may be straight line, the road may be in curve line. So we have to consider it is a straight line moment. Okay. So that possesses what? Rectilinear motion. If the road is in curve, that depends upon the situation, students. Okay. That may be rectilinear motion, that may be a curvilinear motion. Okay. That depends upon the type of the road. Okay. So like this we have to understand how the objects possess the motion. This is particularly about translatory motion. This is particularly about translatory motion. Translatory motion is of two types. One is rectilinear motion and curvilinear motion. And with different examples you have to understand what is rectilinear motion and what is curvilinear motion, students. Okay. And you just try to remember these terms and the definitions of these terms, students, and you note it down in your notebooks and present it in our WhatsApp group. Okay. And learn and be prepared for the test, students. Thank you for listening. Thank you one and all.